In this video, I'll show you how to easily create a lightweight and reusable context menu for your React web application. It will behave like the native browser context menu, you can style it however you like, and you can add any items you like. Let's do it! We will start with this empty project that I created using Create React App with a TypeScript template, so we have this typical empty React project here. The first step is to create a component called context menu, which will render the context menu, but will also be the parent container for the elements for which it will display the context menu. So I create a props object that contains an ID, the items, and a callback function that will be called when an item is kicked. Then I create state variables for a boolean value, indicating whether the context menu is open or not, and for the position of the context menu. Then I render a div that contains the children we get from the props and the actual context menu if it is visible. The context menu is a simple unordered list, where each item is a list item, the caption is rendered within that list item, and when an item is clicked, we hide the context menu and call the callback function we got from the props. Next, I create a CSS file for the context menu and add some styles to make our context menu look a little fancy. It is important that we set the position to absolute. I import the CSS file into the component and apply the class to the unordered list. But what I also need to do is set the position of the context menu using the left and top CSS properties, and I use the values from the state variable here. Looks pretty good, I would say, but of course one important thing is still missing, the context menu handler that opens the menu. I create a handler function that first calls preventDefault to prevent the browser's default behavior, which would be to show the browser's normal context menu. Then I make the menu visible and set the position of the menu by reading the client X and client Y properties from the event. And this handler function is then used for the onContextMenu event on the div. Okay, so now it's time to try and see if our context menu works. So we are going to integrate it into the app component. For the first try, I'm going to show a context menu for this link element here. So I integrate the component and wrap it around the link. Then of course I need to specify the props. So I give it an ID, an item click handler, and some items. If we now switch to the browser, we can see that it works. Awesome. But we are not finished yet. At the moment, it's not possible to hide the menu again. For example, if the user hits escape or clicks somewhere outside the context menu. Let's fix that. We go back to our context menu component and add an event listener for the key down event, where we handle the user hitting the escape key on the keyboard. Then I want to handle the click outside the context menu. To do this, I create a ref that I associate with the unordered list item. Then I create a new click handler where, if the menu is visible, I get the current bounding rectangle of the unordered list and then check if the clicked position is outside this rectangle. If that's the case, then I hide the context menu. And this works perfectly. Whenever the menu is open and I click somewhere else or press the escape key, the context menu closes. So things are looking pretty good, but there's still one problem we need to solve. To see what the problem is, I'll add another context menu to the page for the image element. This works pretty well too, but if we open the context menu and then the other one, we see that both are visible. In fact, you would expect one menu to close when the other one is opened, but that doesn't happen yet, because at the moment all the context menu component instances are independent and don't know about each other. Let's fix that. And I will do this by firing a custom event with the ID of the menu whenever it is opened. That's the first step. The second step is to listen to this event, also in the context menu component. In the handler, I check the ID of the opened menu, and if it is not my own ID, I close the menu. Simple as that. And when I try this in the browser, I see that it works perfectly. I open the context menu, and the other one closes. Perfect. And that's it. What I really like about this approach is that it is really lightweight. It didn't take a lot of code, and it is really easy to use wherever we need it. Plus, we can style the context menu just like any other HTML element, so CSS is the only limit here. What do you think of this implementation? How would you do it differently? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss future videos. Bye.